Hi, what's up, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we're going to discuss Upper Darby and what makes it special and why it may be considered a great place for you to consider to move to. In today's video, we're going to talk about Upper Darby. Upper Darby is a suburb just right outside of Philadelphia. It's literally right outside of West Philadelphia. One of the better neighborhoods to live in outside of the city, and especially in the state of Pennsylvania. And, you know, a lot of people, and the thing about Upper Darby, what makes it special is it's so diverse. So let me just start by saying, like, Upper Darby, yes, it is a suburb outside of Philadelphia, and it is, like, literally, you just take one route, it's Marshall Road, which turns into Spruce Street when you get to 63rd Street in Philadelphia, if I'm even getting the right road right. I just know it by driving, but yes, it's, you take that road, you can get through to it through, from Upper Darby, like just plain true Upper Darby. You can get into Philly pretty quickly, literally from Marshall Road, which turns into Spruce Street when you hit 63rd Street, which is Cobbs Creek. Once you cross over that threshold, you're in Philly. And then there's also Market Street in Philly literally continues on into 69th Street in Upper Darby. And it can also, and it merges and changes into Westchester Pike. And you can also get into it from Township Line Road. If that's the right road, if I'm getting that correctly, I'm probably not. But there's so many routes to get into. I just see it as like Township Line Road, but you can get in and out of the city pretty quickly if you live in West Philly, or if you just live in Upper Darby, you can get into other areas. So Upper Darby has been like one of those main areas that even as an agent, if I'm listing a property, that's one of the areas that I always gravitate to. Like, okay, I know this property is close to Upper Darby, and Upper Darby literally has like everything. So Upper Darby has, let alone not just from like just an access point, you also have transportation. You have 69th Street, like, and I always keep saying 69th Street, the 69th Street terminal, and that terminal basically is like a hub. It's a big hub that you can get on the Market L from. That's our subway, one of our subway systems. And then the trolleys as well. And the trolleys take you in and out the city and into other places out into the suburbs. Regional rail, yes, the trains do come in there, come in and out of there, and buses. So it's really just a whole hub of every connector that you can get into Philly right there. That is literally right outside the city. I don't think there's any other places where you can catch the Market L, the Market Frankfurt line, which is our local line, and it's the blue line, to get into the city, you know, anywhere else outside of Philadelphia. So really, most people get to, 69th Street is considered either the beginning of the line for some folks or the end of the line, depending on where you're coming from and where you're starting as well. So I took a couple of notes, and you know, I lived in Southeast Philly, not Southeast Philly, so long. I lived in Delaware County. If you watch several of my videos, I lived in Delaware County. I'm from this area. I lived in Philadelphia for about 10 years and just decided to move back. The reason why I'm talking about Upper Darby, because Upper Darby is one of those towns that every time I talk to somebody, they always talk about Upper Darby. Whether or not they want to be close to it because of its easy access to everything around the area, or it's there for, you know, for their school systems and even outside of the school system as well, like for the culture. And one of the things that I can, if you ask me about Upper Darby at all, I will tell you it's literally 1% of the entire world's population. No joke. Because it is super diverse. You got every representative of just about every country and every culture in that small town. It's not even so much a small town. It is a little town. But in that town. Because like Upper Darby, it's not just... You got people that live from all walks of life. And the school district has been extremely phenomenal throughout the years. It's from what I always remember and always think of, that I remember that from some of the kids that I used to grow up around and people that I knew that went to the school, to that school district, they had a lot of opportunities that my own school didn't really have at the time. Now my alma mater has those opportunities now. But a lot of people go there for, you know, it's outside of the city. You have the suburb life mixed with the urban feel. So there's a couple main streets. So I'll start here. So let's talk about the main streets. Main streets of Upper Darby is, you got Marshall Road, you got Long Lane, and 69th Street. And I'm just popping these out. These are just main roads that I know of. And what else? You got Long Lane, you got Church Lane, but the Church Lane is really more so Yaden, but it all ties together because all the roads kind of lead into, they all merge and change their names into other areas. But let's just start with 69th Street. 69th Street is really been, is basically a shopper's. It's the main shopping area. You have major commercial retailers such as H&M. You have the Gap Outlet. You have Foot Locker. You also have Marshall's and Burlington Coat Factory. Just right there. There's easy parking. Back then, there used to be a movie theater. I don't know if the movie theater is still there, or I think they revamped the movie theater. I haven't been back to the movie theater, but there was a movie theater that was there. And then also you have the Tower Feet Theater that faces 69th Street Terminal. And the Tower Feet Theater has, that's one of the main, like also one of the major venues that you can get see select for different performances from comedians, groups, and other entertainment, music that's been there. I know that they had, like, since I have young kids, I know the Wiggles were there at one point. I think and some other acts that's been there at the Tower Theater, and it still functions today. Yes, it looks a little outdated, but you know what? It's fine. And you have plenty of shops in between those major commercial retailers, that like also little small businesses. So you have hairdressers, you have barbershops, you have variety stores, and any, like, if you need electronics, if you need clothes, you get some fast fashions. I know there was a Rainbow down there at one point. I don't know if it's there anymore, but you have different sects of that. And even just speaking, like, even if I go back memory lane, there used to be a Sears there, where Sears was really popping over there. And outside of the, but yeah, it's like 69th Street, the 69th Street shopping area has been, and I'm just going to be frank and be honest, it has changed over the years. When I was a kid, there was bigger and I would say somewhat more better stores. Not to say that the stores ain't all that great, but it was really more easier to get to, and they had a little bit more stores that were more worthwhile to go to, in my opinion. But outside of the Sears, that was really, Sears was like the one major, was one of the last major department stores that was there without having to go to Granite Run Mall or go downtown or go anywhere else or King of Prussia. But when they closed the Sears, now it's like you have Marshalls, you have Burlington Coat Factory, you have Foot Locker, you got everything else over there. But regardless, it's a really good shopping, because really, if you're like, it still serves the purpose that if you need to get anything, you could literally get anything, you know, down 69th Street at all. So if you need to get gifts for a party, you can get some last minute gifts for Christmas shopping, or you have an event, you can get a really nice outfit. Everything's there. There's shoe stores. There's a whole bunch of stuff there. There's also a Dollar General now. So basically, it's literally like a little shopper's. You can get everything there just within that strip. And that strip is just, it's literally about like a block, I think about a block and a half on the main lot, on that main avenue, on that main strip. And then you have the stores and businesses that are on the side of it, which are, again, you got variety stores, you have convenience stores, you have different, you have bars, you got schools there. There's the Prism Career Education Academy that's there. You have the ROTC that's there, like for military, for recruitment. You got also grocery stores as well. And I'm not saying like the major grocery stores. Yes, there is the Fresh Grocer that is on Church Lane as well, but there's also like little grocery stores for cultures as well. You have the H Mart, which sells primarily Asian cuisine, like Asian groceries. So the H Mart is like, I believe it's a Korean chain, but it's serviced the Asians, and as well, but not just Asians, but it has, but that's what their specialty is. And there's also other grocery stores that service the other cultures. So you have culture that is there, you have a shopping area for that. So there's different grocery stores that service different cultures. Upper Darby just has everything. So literally, when I say it's literally a piece of the world, you have the piece of the entire world. So name your country. You got a representative that lives in that area. And yeah, and not only that, and that's just the shopping. So beyond that, you have the entertainment, which I touched on, which was the Tower Theater. You also have bars. There's plenty of bars that are over there. And not only just around 69th Street, but sprinkled throughout the Upper Darby neighborhood, the Upper Darby town. Now, let's talk about the school. Let's talk about schools for a minute. Upper Darby also has its own school district. It's also, believe it or not, it's Upper Darby School District. Upper Darby School District is a very huge school district. It serves not only Upper Darby, which is the town, it serves Drexel Hill, which is a part of Upper Darby. They share the same, I don't think they share the same zip code, but you have Drexel Hill. Drexel Hill is a huge neighborhood and a huge area within Upper Darby. You also have Sea Cane, you also have Clifton Heights that it services, and I feel like there is another one, and I think that's it. So between you got those four towns, I feel like there's another one, but I think I got most of it. So you have Upper Darby, Drexel Hill, you have Clifton Heights, and you have parts of Alden and Sea Cane. Yeah, Alden as well, parts of Alden and Sea Cane. Depending on what side you are in, that of course everything is by boundary, so depending on what side of the street, what side of the boundary you are, you could be in one area, you can belong to another school district, or you could belong to one or the other. Of course, it all depends on what your address is and where you are within that map and the boundaries. So because it serviced all those towns, you have a lot of schools. So Upper Darby is known to have about 10 elementary schools all throughout their district. pretty big. Then it goes down to two middle schools. So you have two middle schools. So you take all those 10, you dwindle it down to two middle schools. And again, it all comes down to the catchment, where you are in the boundaries. And it all leads up into one giant high school. And the high school is on Lansdowne Avenue. And it is, and the high school is, you have a couple other high schools there. You have the, not only do you have the public high school, which is right there on Lansdowne Avenue, but you also have the private schools. It's two of them. One's for girls, one's for boys. And they are locally, they're known as Ponder and Prendy. It's Monsignor Bonner and Archbishop Prendy. And those are right there. So you have, if you're coming from, say, Garrett Road, going up the hill on in Lansdowne, you hit Archbishop Prendy and the Catholic school. You get, it's the Catholic high schools. You have a big field right there, a big football field. Then you go down the road, you hit the hospital, which is Delaware County Memorial Hospital, and then you hit the high school, which is Upper Darby High School. There, and it serves a lot, and yes, it's a big school district, so it services a lot of kids. So growing up as a kid, I knew that it was a really big school district, and not only services just the public school, but it also services the private schools. So one thing about, and a lot of people that I know, they go, of course, school districts are very important. So do your research when you're considering to move into an area, whether or not it's good for your family or not, but always research the schools. So I have a link down below where you can find out, or I'll put a link up here somewhere where you can go and do your research about the schools. So, but yes, Upper Darby is a pretty big school district. And it services, like I said, about four to five towns it services. So, yes, and just letting you know, and this is one of the cons that I have, is like the traffic. So imagine coming through, when you have a lot of kids that come out around like 2:30, you got the traffic in the morning. You got the traffic before school, like around 7:30. If they start school around 7:30, around 7 o'clock to 9, it's a lot of traffic. You got two lanes going to and from, and you got the middle lane and you have a lot of traffic in the mornings getting in if you're passing those schools. Right at the bottom of the hill, after you pass the schools, you have another shopping district. You have Bond Shopping Center in that little area. So those areas it's considered Drexel Hill, but it's also a part of Upper Darby. And I'll do another video separate on Drexel Hill, but I know I'm just really focusing on Upper Darby in as a town in and of itself. And I'm just gonna stick within that. And I know this is kind of I'm probably becoming a little bit more scattered, but in essence, it's a big area. It's a big town, and even though it feels like it's a big town, it's also a small town. And the reason why I say it's small and big at the same time is because Upper Darby also, like some people think of Upper Darby, some people also think of Drexel Hill. And some people that think of Drexel Hill, they don't think of themselves as Upper Darby. So basically, for the main purposes of this video, and maybe I'll just try and clean this up some way, somehow, with future Victoria during the editing, is to make that clear. So when I talk about Upper Darby that's my cat upstairs. So when I talk about Upper Darby, so that's schools. That's that. But when I'm talking about Upper Darby, Upper Darby, you have not only so much shopping, you've got literally everything. You have everything from places to worship. There's so many in there, and it's super diverse. And what I mean, and there's like there's a lot of communities in the area. And another good thing, and let's talk about real estate. So I'm going to segue into real estate, of course, because this is a real estate channel, somewhat educational real estate channel. So just talking about Upper Darby in its of itself. Like I said, I talked about how extremely diverse it is. Not only is it diverse from the people that live in there, it's also diverse in the amount of homes that's there. So let's talk, so speaking of real estate, gotta give you some stats. Median price point in Upper Darby is $150,000 sale price, and the median rent is around $1,100 for rent for like just basically an average 3-bed, 1.5-bath in Philadelphia, but in Upper Darby. Upper Darby considers not only just like, like I said earlier in this video, it's a mixture of both urban and suburban feel. So you get that mixture. So if, so we, I know we spend a lot of time in Philadelphia. Philadelphia is known to have a lot of single, row homes. Upper Darby has row homes as well. The and because with the suburban feel, there's also quite a few single family homes, single detached homes, as well as twin homes as well. So you get a really good mixture. Upper Darby, primarily, depending on what section you are, depending on if you're like, say for instance, if you are like say in the middle of Upper Darby, there's another area. You have like between Marshall Road and Lansdowne Avenue, you have a lot of row homes. Say like if I'm just on the left side, because I'm not very good with directions, but I'll follow up this video. Maybe I need to just, I'll take it to a map on another video. But anyway, this is just basically a basic synopsis, but you have row homes. You have the row homes within Upper Darby, which are, you know, which is a good mixture. You know, they are rents, you know, you can rent them, and those are also homeowners as well. So you have a good mixture of homeowners and renters that live in the area all throughout. You also have areas where it's a little bit more spread out. Like so for instance, on in a part of Garrett on an Upper Darby closer to Beverly Hills High School, middle school, it's considered Beverly Hills area. You have on one side of the tracks, and I'm not trying to be negative here, you have a trolley train that runs from 69th Street and it goes out into further out into Delaware County, so it passes by the high schools. The trolley, on the left side of the trolley, and this is my left, on the left side of the trolley, you have a lot of single family homes where the homes are a lot big or pretty big. They are like, you know, $300,000 to $400,000 homes, depending on how great they, on how good they are, depending on the condition, of course. And then on the right side, you have a little bit more, more row homes, and it's more of a denser area. One thing about, and like I said before in previous videos, that once you get out into the counties, your taxes do get higher. The home prices are a little bit lower, but Upper Darby is known to have higher taxes because of the school district, not only because of the school district, but also because of the property as well. So if you're looking to budget within your taxes, and you want to be, you know, and Upper Darby taxes tend to be more north, like on average, north of like around 3,000, 3,400, like you can pay as much as like $10,000 in taxes in Upper Darby if you have like a single family detached house. You know, depending on it, but whereas if you have a row home, your taxes tend to be a little bit more economical, more around like $3,000 to $3,000 for taxes if you have a row home. And again, you have mixtures of homeowners to renters to tenants. And everybody does tend to take care of their properties. Upper Darby is still a very great place to live in. you have a lot of opportunities in the area, let alone for, and there's parks that's there that, you know, and you know, within the schools and everything. I mean, I remember I showed a property in around the Upper Darby School District, and I'm just saying the district because I was in Drexel Hill at the time. There was a school at the corner, and during one of my showings, I brought my son with me, and he wanted to go play at the playground, so we went and played at the playground at the elementary school that was there, because he saw the playground, and it wasn't fenced off. But, you know, regardless, it's a pretty safe area. You have parks around, and you also have, you have not only so much of a transportation, like, really, and virtually, you don't really need a car. If everything, you have everything within Upper Darby if you don't need a car. Because you have the public transportation system that is so, that it literally is a hub. You have the buses that run throughout the streets. You have the, you have the train station that you know, that you can catch either the trolley, the bus, the sub, or the train to get you anywhere in the city or outside of the city that you would like. There's also a different part of Upper Darby as well that is further up Westchester Pike, where it's, you know, yes, it can be dense in some places. Yes, it can be, you know, you have a lot of people. There's a lot of people that live in Upper Darby. And actually, no, now that I'm thinking about it, there is another town, and I really just thought about it just now. It's Millbourne. There is another town called Millbourne, and it's literally like, Millbourne is a very, very small town. It has its own fire department and its own police department. It has its own borough hall. It has its own stuff, but it feels like two blocks. But it's a part of Upper Darby. It's a part of the Upper Darby School District. So, you know, it's a pretty big, it's a big but also a small town as well. Everybody tends, and people do care about their town. Over the years, it has dipped a little bit. It has, like, not so much dip gone downhill. I wouldn't say that. I would say that it definitely has changed as over time, as any community that has over time, when you have, you know, when you have change and more people come into the area. And then because it's such a big area, because Upper Darby is such a huge area, it does service a lot of communities. And I mean, like I said, and I'll keep saying it, it's literally 1% of the entire world population is just in that one town. And I feel that. Because you can experience every culture. There's restaurants for every little culture. That's every culture. Every culture that's there. You have between Latin cuisine, from African cuisine. You have soul food. You have Asian food. You have Indian food. You have a lot of cuisines and different that's there, and different market, like different shops, and you can get just about anything from around there, whether or not, like, and there's a lot of there's boutiques, there's shopping boutiques, and there's shopping districts where you can go. There's also, like, of course, you have your standard Wawa and your main grocery store. The main grocery store there is really fresh, the fresh grocer. And then you have your furniture warehouse, but it feels like it. But you have literally everything there that you don't really have, like, if you don't really have to leave the town unless you want to go somewhere else to buy your goods and whatnot. But you don't really have to leave because everything is literally right there. They have stuff for kids. Just speaking about Upper Darby High School, as a kid, they have a really good arts program. Very good, phenomenal performing arts program and arts program for their students. They have a good music program as well. Of course, it's up there. You know, they have, there's nothing, from what I always used to talk about, like when I, like I said, growing, I always knew the students that went there had a lot of opportunities. Like they got to travel, they got to go to different countries, depending on whatever program they were in. They were able to, they, you know, outside of course, the traditional Spanish and French that you would learn, I think that they had a lot more cultures there that, you know, yeah, you had somebody that was like, that would speak, French, like you had a lot of like second, like English is your second language there, classes, because it was super diverse. You had a lot of people that came from all over the world, all from, and different, like when I mean how diverse, and I'm not even kidding, and I know I've been saying that all throughout this video, it is super diverse and it's no joke. So if you have like, if you know, if you want to enrich yourself in other cultures and in other, you know, to be in, like and learn from other people, like literally you can, Upper Darby, you're not going to learn it from it, you're going to learn it from other places, but you know, you know, there's not, it's, you know, and same thing as Philly. Philly has a lot, is extremely diverse as well. But of course, Upper Darby, like Philadelphia School District is a huge school district, because it's a school district in and of itself within this county, because it's a huge county. And with several high schools and several middle schools and hundreds of elementary schools. But regardless, this is like one of, this is, like Upper Darby's really has a lot of, like between 10 elementary schools leading up to one high school. And of course they branch off. You get kids that go to the private schools. There's several private schools that are in the Upper Darby area and Drexel Hill area. But regardless, there is a lot of, you can get a lot of opportunity, because there's a lot of people that do tend to want to move into Upper Darby. Of course, I'm going to end this video, follow up video with just going through the town. It's, you know, just to kind of, so that way you can see and find out what's going on within the town and know where everything is, and to kind of get a better perspective on what I'm saying. So thank you so much. I really appreciate it, and I look forward to seeing you on my next one. Thanks. Have a good one.